In this section, we have the pleasure of welcoming Jennifer Kohoko, who will facilitate today's workshop on medicine teachings and lead us in a conversation on self-care as we make our own medicine bag. Following this, we'll engage in a special conversation with the Honorable MPP and friend of the UFCW, Wab Kinu. Now, a bit more about Jennifer Kohoko. Jennifer is a member of the Algonquins of Pitwakanagan First Nation. She is the Indigenous Healing and Wellness Coordinator of the Odawa Native Friendship Center, working mainly in the area of mental health, addictions, culture, and violence against women. Over to you, Jennifer.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for having me. I would like to talk today about self-care. It's very important for everyone who engages in advocacy to take some time for themselves. And one way we could do that is to just take the time for yourself. And today we're going to be constructing a medicine bag. And I believe everyone has their kits ready to go. So I'm just going to start unpacking my stuff here. And I'm just going to adjust my laptop so you'll be able to see me working alongside you to construct this. All right, so I'm just pulling out all the materials that I went ahead and I separated all the medicines. Put in the bag after. And so here we are going to start with getting the bag. And the first step is to get your wooden bead. And I'm just going to take it out. And get your needle and your sinew. I'm going to take this off. And thread my needle. And make a knot that's not going to pass through the leather when you sew your wooden piece on. I'd recommend maybe knotting it about 3 times at least. So there's this is number 3 now. Can everyone see okay? Okay, so there's 3. I'm just going to do 1 more, just in case. All right, I'm going to take my wooden bead and I'm going to be placing it. First of all, you should line up your the hole here. This is where you're going to be sewing it on the side. So just line it up and then you can fold down the top, see how it will be fitting after. And from there, you can mark the spot where your bead will be going. I got a red pencil crayon just so it wouldn't be visible after. I'm just going to mark it And then there's actually, they might already have put in a spot already. So that, yeah, they have. I'm just going to mark my own. Mine's a little bit higher, so I'll just go with that one. Okay, so now you will go in from the back. I'm going to try and get it in into the spot that I marked. Just pull it through. So you take your bead, you go through it once, you're going to go through it another time just so it will stabilize the bead. And try to get it as close and tight as possible. And then you'll be going back in through your entry point. And that is fairly secure. So I'm just going to tie it off in the back. And I'm going to go through the leather. Not very far, but just enough to have a little bit to secure. And I'll go through that little thread. I'm going to wrap it around twice. So that should be secure. I'm actually going to take my needle off And so here's the other end of the thread. I'm going to take my thread and just tie it off using that end as well. To make it extra secure. I'll go through one more time. And that should be good. You can flatten out your bead. I forgot to mention that it would be a good idea to have scissors on hand. I'm just going to trim this off. And the next part is okay, so next we're going to get our string. I'll just unwrap it. And this part, we're going to measure the length that would be suitable for the length. So I'm just going to trim this a little bit. I can get it in the needle. This part's a little bit tricky if your hide is thick. So we're going to go in from the back. In the first hole, I'm going to take my needle off of this side. I'll just pull it through. And for this part, you'll want to ensure that your hide is not twisted. So just run your fingers along and take the twists out of the hide. I'm going to trim this part. Put it in the needle. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to ensure that the twists are all out again before I proceed. Okay, I'm going to go in the back, go through the back on the other side of the first hole on the top. And pull it through. So this is where you're going to fit it to your neck to see if you like the length of it. Okay, I like this length. You'll also want to ensure that the two lengths that have been pulled through are similar, as much as you can get it. Okay, I'm going to start lacing up the side. I'm going to turn the hide so the smooth side is showing. And I'll go in through the back again. Again, make sure your hide isn't twisted. Make sure it's the same tightness all the way down. So with the last one, you're going to tie a knot. Right here. To ensure that it doesn't come out later. to try to get that knot as close as possible. And after it, you can either trim this or leave it long, your choice. Okay, I'm gonna do the other side now. Thread it. This part is tricky. So I'll be going in through the back again. Make sure there's no twists in your hide. You want to make sure that it's fairly tight, but not too tight. And that it's consistent all the way down. Okay, so here's the last hole. And again, you're going to tie a knot. At the bottom. So now I'm going to start filling my bag with the medicines. I'm going to start with tobacco. In your kits that you received, there's quite a bit of medicines extra, so you could just save it for a later date. I don't think you could get it all in here. So I'll start with tobacco. Cedar. stage. Okay. I'm going to fold it before I put it in. You also received some. I received two sort of gems for healing. I'll put them into. Well, now that my bag is done, I'm going to smudge it. I use H. Normally I would use matches, but I can't find them. I'm going to use a lighter today. So by smudging the bag, it will ensure that you're cleansing it, and it will now be like your personal your own personal spirits within this bag. So I'm just going to switch my laptop view. So the medicines help us to for self-care. There's different ways we can use it. For tobacco, we would hold it in our left hand and make a prayer. And then we can either burn the tobacco or offer it to a tree. And those would carry our prayers up to the spirit, great spirit. For the cedar, we could, for self-care, we could make cedar tea. make a cedar bath. And drinking cedar tea helps toxins leave your body. So it's important that we take care of ourselves in that way. For sage, sage is usually well considered to be like a woman's medicine. And we can smudge ourselves with the sage and our objects. We can smudge with all these medicines, actually. I like sage. I use sage. Some people like to use sweetgrass. For the sweetgrass, yeah, it could be considered as the hair of Mother Earth. And some people will actually braid it and put it in their hats. And this way, like, if they're going into a difficult situation, it can help them, like, protect themselves mentally. And smudging with sweetgrass also is good for our self-care.